Ladies and gentlemen, thank you for our opportunity to presentation on the topic of inclusive electoral education through informal education channel in Indonesia. Special thanks for Dr. Nazim Zaidi, Chairman of Indian Election Commission. The first, I will give some brief information on Indonesia election, and then the second for the special topic on the education for voters with disability in Indonesia. You know that Indonesia, known as a maritime and archipelago countries with 17,000 islands, and Indonesia have 34 provinces and then 514 regencies or municipalities and 7,160 districts, 83,184 sub-districts or villages. And the population about 237 million based on census to 2010, and then voter list on 2014 election about 187 million. And for the 2014 turnout rate about 75%. We have 450 ballot design based on the district in election. We have three kind of election: the first parliamentary election, and then presidential election, and the third concurrent governor and region or mayor election or local election. Indonesia held 11 times election in revolution era, held on 1955, and then transition new order 1971, and the new order era there are five election, and in the early of reformation era in 1999, and now as known as a democratic consolidation Indonesia, we held three election: 2004, 2009, and 2014. This is the data with comparative approach. Political parties in 2004 election, it's 24, and then on 2009, 44 parties with 38 national parties and 6 local parties in Aceh province. And for the 2014 election, there are 15 political parties, and the voters is increased. In the last election, 2004, there are 187 million. Voting turnout on last election, 2014, 75%. And the polling places, polling station, we have 545,778. This is the structure of General Election Commission Indonesia. The permanent body in national level, provincial level, and regency or municipality. And we have ad hoc body in the sub-district election committee, voting committee, and the polling station officer. In the overseas, we have an election committee, and then polling station officer is based on our embassy or consulate general in overseas. Now, in the special topic, we have two meaning of the voter education. In the non-electoral period, we mean that voter education as civic education, and then in the electoral period, it means further education. Goals of further education: increase participation, increasing literacy politics, and increase volunteer. We have two group of target in the cluster one. In general, young voters, women, disability and marginal, and the religion. And the second cluster with the contextual or special issues, regional voter turnout law, regional potential conflict of election violation, and then conflict region. Material of voter education is based on the institutional, election, political participant, under-relevant material, and democracy material. For the inclusive electoral education through informal education channel, educate a broad range of stakeholder and special group of voters about the importance of being voters, like women voters, first-time voters. We make a program KPU, a general election of commission, goes to campus, voter with disability. We made braille template, ballot paper, technical guidance for accessible polling station for voters with disability, and then voter education for people with disability, and potential marginalized voter. And we make a synergy with civil society organization to establishment of voter education media center in collaboration with national CSOs, improve information on election process, and engage the public more directly in voter outreach, distribute KPU material, election commission material, and then consolidate guidance and lesson product learned from the 2014 election. Accessible election for voter with disability. Indonesian Election Commission has committed to conduct accessible election for voter with disability as an institution that have authorities on conducting the election. KPU make effort to protect and fulfill citizen with disability right on politics by issuing regulation which inclusive giving affirmative action for voter with disability, cooperate with other institutions and stakeholder concerned on disability. We have several states giving affirmative action to voter with disability. The first, regulation drafting process states, KPU working with stakeholder to collect aspiration and recommendation regarding how to make an accessible election for voter with disability, and then make a MOU with people disability organization to provide a better accessible election. KPU already increasing cooperation with disability organization in formulating KPU regulation relating to disabled voter. For example, KPU regulation for accessible election, one election socialization target is voter with disability. Polling station has to be accessible for voter with disability. And then KPU giving access to citizen with disability on public debate for presidential candidate. A physical and spiritual requirement cannot deter citizen with disability on a candidacy. In the second stage, voter registry, we have some coding, number of voter with disability. We have coding in the voter list, number one, number of voter with physical impairment, number of voter with vision impairment, and number of voter with hearing impairment, number of voter with mental disability and others. So we can, make a plan well how to serve the voter with disability in the polling station. In the third socialization stage, like in the photo, in presidential debate 2014, we have a sign language interpreter on television. KPU collaborated with TV station in broadcasting president and vice president debate, where in the debate there is also sign language interpreter. And then we specific budget to educate voters with disability to make brochure, leaflet, other education material. In the voting stage, KPU regulation explained the things as follow. In innovative to vote at the polling station should be mentioned to ease for people with disability in voting at the polling station. Table or board of voting booth and for making the ballot and the table with empty space permitted for people with disability using wheelchair. The entrance and exit polling at least 90 centimeter size in order to ensure access for people with disability motion using the wheelchair, and location of polling station should be easily accessible in flat place that is not rocky, not hilly, not thick grassy, not jump over ditch and exhibit the stair. Based on monitoring finding on issue accessible pathway to the polling station for person with a disability, we are growing more better from 30% to 70% more accessible, and based on the location, now more accessible in 68% entrance of polling station, 84%. And then based on the monitoring finding too, exit should be at least 90 centimeter in width in order to guarantee access for wheelchair user. It's more better increase on 81%. Based on space, 62%, and booth, 66%. For the ballot box table with sufficient height for easy access for wheelchair user, it's increase in 66%, in braille template 65%. KPU design and produce electoral information dissemination material in braille format for voter with vision impairment, like in the photo, and then this braille template legislative election. And we have many cooperation with many institution concerned to disability. And the end, Indonesian Election Commission get award from Government of Republic Indonesia for its effort to protect and fulfill political rights for citizens with disability. Thank you.